mathematics department at Duke University, high-ranking university. Now, let's start with his mathematics. Right, eight people. To repopulate the Earth, you need 3 men and 5 women. All of whom...
repopulate,
there's no one here.
Produce,
right. Right, okay, repopulate, produce. You need 3 men and 5 women. Right, who must not be related to each other by blood.
I'm just making a comment.
The women must give birth to 20.
But listen, you have to establish
because, okay, all humans today, despite having right, descend from a very small population in Africa, perhaps 5 to 10,000 breeding pairs about 70,000 years ago. That's what we're talking about. Okay, so let's go. Yeah, but they've proven it. Okay, let's read. Now let's read the mathematics. Is it just the mathematics, guys?
All right, good.
Okay, right. The women must give birth to 25 babies each, beginning at age 16 to 80, and you will hit the million mark. Just by 8 women giving birth to 25 babies. Now, does anybody know any woman that's given birth to 25 babies?
Yes.
I know a few men has.
My grandmother.
Your grandmother?
23 survived.
Yeah. Right, you need 5 more women that did that.
No more did that.
Okay, great.
Had 11.
No, what I'm saying, does anybody know 5 women that did that? So, to repopulate, okay, but Adam and Eve, then you can't produce 7 billion people on the planet. Right, you can't do it. 2 can't do it. But guys,
it can be done though, it can be done.
Okay.
So stripped along
now, okay. So like, let's think about the logic then, right? Adam and Eve, let's go with that story. Adam and Eve produced Cain and Abel.
So we're working with logic.
One second.
Wait, we're working on the premise of logic.
Now let's go with Adam and Eve first.
We're working on the premise of logic.
Yeah,
right? So what I want to establish is, are you saying that it is absolutely without a shadow of a doubt impossible that 2 people could populate the whole earth?
100%.
Because based on
and,
that,
and populate, and populate, and populate with the vast variety of human beings that you see here.
Where did the 8
Because everybody's not, the same kind.
But who says,
where did the 8
Everybody's different.
Right, but who's to say?
So you have to have a variety in the genetic society.
Well, it wasn't only 2. They were just the examples.
Who's to say that those first two?
Because
Adam
and Eve. So Adam and Eve.
Example, my brother. Never get it wrong. It was just an example.
Okay. Adam and Eve, right? So they said Eve came from Adam's rib. Right. That means genetically they're connected.
Yes.
Because the rib is just
bone
marrow. So Adam and Eve are exact replica, same genetics. Yeah. They produce a baby, Cain and Abel.
Okay, cool.
Cain wipes out Abel, Cain's left. There's only 3 people on the planet.
Wait. Who says
hold on,
but did he wipe that? Wait, did he wipe them down before they produce?
Wait a second.
Hold on a second.
So, can you tell me where in the Quran or Judaism where it says Adam and Eve
had
daughters?
Wait, in a hadith there was Cain and Abel. Yeah,
Cain and Abel.
Yeah, they each had twins. They had each had twin sisters.
But hold on.
Right, wait.
There were just 2 subject matters. There were more people.
The hadith. You should have asked me. So let me finish.
Let me say. Okay. Let me say what actually says. In the Torah, Cain.
No, but you asked him
Cain
about the Quran. No?
Cain killed Abel, and after that, he got banished
to the land of Nod.
To the land of Nod,
that's in the Torah.
Where he found his wife.
That's right.
And God put a mark on him for nobody to touch him.
That's right.
Are these nobodies to touch him?
That's in the Torah.
But that's the Torah. That's where you get your story. Story's wrong.
Always the right one.
The story's wrong.
So your one's the right one.
I'm not here to reinforce anyone. I'm not here to reinforce anyone.
I will tell you. don't know how he lived there.
How could two people who are related?
We came from two.
You have to go by process of elimination.
Exactly. So we keep going back to our parents.
How do you know that their DNA didn't?
Yeah.
How do you know that their DNA didn't encompass all the seven?
If you keep on going back,
but it doesn't say it did.
It's going to be one dad and one mum.
But it didn't say it did.
Who said? Who doesn't say it does?
It doesn't say in any
book
that their DNA encompasses every single variety.
No.
It didn't say that.
About DNA.
It just says Adam came. Eve came from Adam's rib. They're genetic related.
Not talking about DNA.
How did that? It doesn't
take
a different variety.
Don't talk about DNA.
It
doesn't talk about DNA. Well, this one's about the creation. I'm not talking about extracting the creation from the loins of Adam.
That's what I'm saying.
You believe in Noah's Ark?
I believe that, Noah.
You believe in it? Yeah, everyone believes Noah's Ark, yeah? Right, shall we look at the actual dimensions in the Torah?
I don't go by the Torah, so you can't give me that.
So, have you got the dimensions in
No, I don't have dimensions.
And we don't have to go by this one.
No, we don't.
If you haven't got the dimensions, you have to go by the ones we have got.
I don't affirm Noah's story according to the Torah.
Because
so you can't tell me to go by it.
After the flood, the earth was repopulated.
Why is
right?
it so hard
it
to
was
get
repopulated
that?
Again, wasn't
Listen,
it?
Who said this? Who said it was the whole earth, though?
So wasn't
who says it's
the whole earth that died?
I don't have any
does
mention.
It say in the top?
It doesn't say
does
the Quran that
wrong?
It doesn't say
what
that.
Happened?
It doesn't say that. It doesn't say that he flooded the whole earth.
Okay. So what part of the earth?
It said that it flooded those oppressive people that lived in Noah's township or his qarya.
Oh, only a town got flooded.
That's what, as far as the Quran mentioned.
Only a town.
No Muslim jurist, yeah, in 1400 years has ever claimed, yeah, that from my knowledge, maybe you
well, that's
can, that has ever claimed that
okay.
the whole earth was flooded.
Okay,
planet.
Okay. Judaism believes that. Christianity believes that the whole world was flooded. Now you guys believe a town was flooded.
Can you see what the problem is now? No, I don't see a problem.
Some people
I don't,
say it's only
I'm
a town.
I'm not.
A lot of people say it was the whole world was flooded.
It doesn't matter if two people lie and I'm telling the truth.
But
doesn't
their story
matter.
Came before
you
yours.
Doesn't matter.
But their story came before yours. Yeah, but doesn't your one's true.
I'm not here to reinforce.
How do I know which one's true?
Are you talking to a Muslim?
I don't know which one's true.
Are you talking to a Muslim or are you talking to a Jewish?
I'm giving you. But you're both telling the same story in different ways.
No. You're trying to refute my story, not the Christian or the Jew.
I'm not.
I'm not going by that. So
you say only a town. Only a town got flooded.
I say there's no proof.
How big was
I'm saying there's no proof. There's no proof
okay.
to show.
Okay, it's Africa. Okay, but the town is Africa. No, but the town is a town.
I don't have
a town. So it says
you know.
It says
you're the guy with the details, yeah. So if you're gonna tell
I'm
me,
I'm trying to help you out.
No,
give
so give me the details according to the Quran and the Sunnah. Don't give me according to Judeo-Christian.
Well, let me go with the Judeo.
Don't give me the Judeo.
Okay, you don't hear it.
Alright, give me the Judeo-Christian. Okay. But don't tell me that that's what I.
Okay, where's the story?
Half of that is made up. So be careful of that tablet there. He showed me a couple of things last time. Didn't exist.
According to the Torah, these were the dimensions of the ark. And you can see that is a football field.
No, you know, they've actually proven scientifically that it wasn't actually that shape, it was a circular shape.
I know, but let's just give it the
It was a spaceship. It was a spaceship.
Now, hold on a second. Now, to put that into context,
it was a spaceship.
Here it is here. This here is the now. This spot here.
But they actually remade the ark. They remade it according to those instructions.
It looks like a canoe.
Still doesn't make it real, but okay.
Yeah. There is Noah's Ark. There is the Queen Mary. There is the Titanic. The Queen ship. Right? The Titanic is twice the size of the ark.
That's to make the planet look small.
How did we get the elephants?
They were tiny elephants.
One elephant on that was sinking. Come on, man.
Really? No, really.
Yes.
You telling me
one elephant there was sinking?
Come on, man.
You had elephant. Come on, you had rhinos.
You had slaves, over 1 million species of animals.
I know. You had slaves for the people.
When you telling me that one elephant is gonna sink a ship?
Have you seen pie?
There's more than
remember
seven of some. Yeah, they took seven of some. Yeah, that's true. There was seven of some.
You remember that pie?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
About the tiger.
You see the tiger? Now, what did the hyena do to the zebra? It didn't last long, did it? Having all the animals together. And then what happened to the hyena? The tiger took him out. So you got 40 days and 40 nights of animals all living together. God trained them,
That's what happened.
And they came off the boat and started to hunt again.
But the kangaroo came off, remember they found it in Mount Ararat. Turkey, right?
So it went all the way.
The kangaroo came off of Turkey and bounced all the way to Australia.
Wow.
Remember that?
Guys, that's what happened to the kangaroo.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I know, but
and then the penguin came off that Turkey and went all the way to Antarctic.
Look at that. What's that? The animals. That's a trick. Came off Turkey and went to Australia.
So remember the Earth was all together then, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't.
So two of the penguins went from Turkey.
Because you are talking about the Paleolithic period, that was over 20 million years ago.
So that was before Noah.
Of course it is.
Kangaroos
but the thing is, you know, like, you lot laugh at these things.
But it's not impossible to take an animal from one. Shall I tell you one of the biggest jokes in it? No. Shall I tell you one of the biggest comedian jokes
in it? Is it impossible? Is it impossible?
The one that gets to me is the talking snake.
That could be metaphorical.
When Evie's walking around and all of a sudden she sees a talking snake.
Why can't it be metaphorical?
The thing, okay.
It wasn't, the snake is talking to her.
It can be.
According to the Bible, the snake
is talking
to her.
It can be, but they don't take it metaphorically. They take it literally. It can be metaphorical.
There's a lot of...
But they say it literally talks.
No, they take it literally. We have talking snakes in the tree. Now, if I saw a talking snake in a tree, I'm bolting that way. I'm not standing there talking to a talking snake.
That's why logic is subjective.
People have been watching too much of Jungle Book. It's not real.
Look, you can say what you like.
I'm giving you logic.
There are some fences that are subjective.
Maybe she understood snake language.
Maybe she understood snake language.
You can say it's out and out ridiculous.
Yeah, but in Africa, yeah, it's not something that you show out here. But we are. Especially in Ghana and Nigeria and West Africa, we are believers of spiritual power, witchcraft, and that sort of stuff.
What's witchcraft mean? I'm talking about people who conjure things or make potions in order to make people ill, to cast, to make them love other people. Have you seen communion in the Roman Catholic Church? That is scary. Here is the blood, here is the body. Cannibalism, vampirism, right? That is scary shit in a... I know, but that's scary shit in a communion.
Why is it scary?
Here is the blood, eat it symbolically.
Symbolically, you just said it. Anyway, I don't back that up. I don't know. Cool, let's take that out. But what you presented me all so far, it's not Quranic.
When you use logic,
it's all Judeo-Christian.
It's following the same story. You haven't given me the number.
He's saying to me that the ark, you haven't got the notice for the ark. These people maintain that they had the measure for the ark. You've just never said that it exists. So why would I not come? This is God's word according to the Torah. Hold on a second. So is the God in the Torah the same as the God in the Quran? The God in the Torah is the Not the one that wrestles with angels.
Hold on a second. But you guys will often refer to the Bible to say, here is God talking about Musa, yes?
Let me qualify my statement. The same God who revealed the Torah, revealed it in its original form, and revealed it in children to Jesus the Messiah, is the same one who revealed the Quran. Now, is the Torah that we have now the same book that he revealed?
No, I didn't say that. I said, is it the same God that's talking to Moses in the Torah? Is that the same God that is throughout
in
the
some
cross?
Places?
In some places. But how could God be in some places?
No, I'll tell you why, because the pen has distorted it.
So they could be
so what? So how do you know that bit's been
the Quran confirms that which is authentic and okay. Whatever it doesn't but confirm, what I'm trying to say throw
the,
away.
The Israelites look at the Quran and say that's been confirmed.
Yeah, but the Israelites disobeyed Moses, their old prophet.
The Christians look at the Israelites and say, as far as the life of Jesus, you guys are going wrong because he did die and he is God and you guys came in.
The Israelites don't disobey their old message.
The Israelites didn't disobey Moses.
No, I'm saying to you, according to Christians,
they did disobey Moses.
God, they worship Baal, but God told them not to worship idols, and they disobeyed. Yes?
Every time.
They were in the wilderness 40 days and 40 nights. Why are you been wandering around?
Why were they not given the promised land?
To walk from Egypt to Canaan, anybody can do that.
If it happened.
So you're saying it's a lie then?
I don't think it happened.
Because it says in the Bible they won't.
Right. Yeah, it says in the Bible a snake spoke to
Egypt
to
the land of Canaan.
But that's from the old book.
You take a week to walk it. Right, it took them 40 days and 40 nights. That's
you
over
believe
the two
it took
months.
Them 40 days and 40 nights. Did they actually get there?
No, Moses didn't do it. Moses stood here just before he got there.
What? His life was at, that was it?
His life was taken out.
That was it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was time for him to go.
That's what he's doing there. He's been walking all that way. And just when you get there, you take him out. That don't make any sense. Why would God not let him taste?
Maybe that there's
going to the land.
Maybe there's a wisdom of him not going to the land. From guys. What befell the Israelites from
all it is, brother, all it is with
but
you. Listen, I want you to just look. Me
you're
having a friend
to Jews or Christian.
No, I'm not. Yeah. I'm just giving you because you said you didn't know the dimension.
I don't. The flooding, but I don't mention that.
I know the flooding you wasn't aware of. Right.
What do you mean that I say the flooding?
Yeah. But also the free will. You have that a bit confused. I'm giving you that. And I'm trying to help you out. You have that bit.
It's not confused.
Because
you're the one
free will means.
Listen. We're not gonna.
Okay. Watch this. I'm gonna demonstrate free will. I say to you now, you can go anywhere in this park, anywhere you want, but don't come here. Have I just contradicted myself?
Yes.
Have I just contradicted myself? You can go anywhere in the world.
Yes, you did.
Anywhere you want, but don't come here. Have I contradicted myself? I just said you can go anywhere in the park.
Anywhere except you've made a concession.
No, anywhere.
Right, and then you
call it. Anywhere. So you haven't got free will to come here.
You made a concession.
Yeah, but I'm just contradicting myself.
You haven't contradicted yourself.
Free will means you can go anywhere you want and do whatever you want without constraint.
A contradiction to your synergy.
Now, contradiction. Now, Allah says this. You can go anywhere you want, do what you want,
but, don't come
but
here.
If you do that, you go in paradise. If you do that, you go in hell. I'm just contradicting myself.
No.
You haven't got free will.
No, you have got free
because
will.
There's a price to pay.
You got free will.
There's a price to pay for it. Free will, there's no price to pay.
What do you mean?
There's no price to pay.
Can I kill someone?
There's no price to pay.
Can I kill someone?
Within the
realms of the earth, not going to the supernatural, I can choose to source you now.
Yeah.
Right. I have the free will to do that.
Yeah.
Will there be consequences?
Yes.
Yeah. I still have free will to do that.
Yes.
Exactly. So the consequence is not.
But hold on a second.
It's not something.
A policeman can talk to you now, and he won't have any consequences.
What do you mean?
A policeman can talk to you now and won't have any consequences.
It doesn't have consequences.
No, it doesn't.
He's bound by the law. Whether the law is executed,
he's
bound by the law.
By men, right. And can be twisted. Remember, I am the law.
But that
and the law in the law that I experience. Can be twisted and bent and put underneath the carpet.
Because it's made by imperfect legislation.
What?
Allah is
no, because the law.
And he sees all and nothing escapes him.
The only law that you have as a human being, everybody has it. Life, yeah? Liberty and property.
You don't have liberty.
That's what I'm saying to you. In your default state, because all animals have the same thing. Life, liberty and property. Right? The only animals that are restricted from that are us. A bird can fly where it wants, a fox can go where it wants, do what it wants. It's not restricted by rules. It doesn't have to pay taxes. It can eat when it wants. You have to make the money to eat. If you didn't make any money, you wouldn't eat.
animals are subservient to us.
No, they don't.
Yes, they are. Horses are in stables.
A lion or bear in the Canadian mountains, eh?
Exactly. So they're subservient to us.
How?
We are the dominant creation on the earth.
Let me see you tell that to a 7-foot grizzly in Canadian mountains.
I'll shoot it with a tranquilizer and say it to its face.
Yeah, but okay, you shoot that's it and another one comes.
But that's not the point. I know that. I know.
And then another one comes.
But that's what.
Pride of lions. How about pride of lions? Lions, listen. I am Tarzan.
If it was the case,
I can joke. And that film's a joke in itself.
I know. Don't you even mention that.
All it is, just think about it. Use a bit of logic, bro. That's what I'm asking you to do.
The thing is, yeah.